Hello, dear students. In the last lecture, we were discussing about the topic the cytoplasmic organelles. The second cytoplasmic organelle that we will discuss in this lecture, that is number two, is mitochondria. Number two is mitochondria, which are also called chondrosomes or chondriosomes. Mitochondria are the chondrosomes. This is the nucleus of the cell, this is the membrane. Mitochondria, these are the spherical or somewhat rod-like structures. These mitochondria, they are double membrane-bounded organelles. These double membrane-bounded organelles, they have outer thin covering that is called unit membrane. This unit membrane is made up of lipids and protein. It is a lipoprotein covering. Inside the mitochondria, there are irregular partition walls. These irregularly folded membranes, these are called cresti, for singular cresta and for plural cresti. Cresti, these are inner folded irregularly partition walled. These irregularly partition walled, the cresti, they keep on producing an important enzyme. They are called oxidative enzymes. The mitochondria, they produce enzyme called oxidative enzymes. Dear students, you know, enzymes are the biocatalyst. They promote the rate of chemical reaction. These enzymes, they promote the process of the oxidation of the glucose. What is the oxidation? Oxidation meaning is simply a burning process of the glucose, or we can say that it is the process during which glucose is burnt or glucose is broken down to release a good amount of the energy. And the energy released by the oxidation of the glucose within the mitochondria, the energy is produced, energy is generated, that is, energy is generated in the form of a compound that is called ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Adenosine triphosphate is a usable chemical energy. This chemical energy, the ATP, which is generated as a result of burning of the glucose within the mitochondria, this energy is called energy currency. Dear students, why ATP is called energy currency? It is energy currency, so called, because just like the currency in the market, it is ready use. And thus, the ATP is also just like a currency, which can be used quickly or rapidly. Thus, the ATP is called energy currency. And as a result of a burning of a single glucose molecule, in net gain, about 36 ATP molecules are generated as a result of burning of the one glucose molecule. Because of this, mitochondria are the chondrosomes, they are called powerhouse of the cell. Powerhouse of cell. Mitochondria are commonly known powerhouse of the cell. They are powerhouse of the cell, so called, because they generate the power. And as a result of this generation of the ATP, mitochondria are called powerhouse of the cell. They are also called center for cellular respiration or center for cellular respiration. Dear students, cellular respiration is a process during which glucose or other organic compounds are burned. This process of the burning of the glucose within the mitochondria of the cell is called cellular respiration. And cellular respiration occurs here in the mitochondria, because of which mitochondria are commonly called center for cellular respiration. Mitochondria, they were discovered by a scientist, Altman. Altman was a scientist who discovered the mitochondria for the first time, you know. Mitochondria, they have semi-autonomous existence in the cell. Mitochondria have semi-autonomous existence. Why it is called a mitochondria have semi-autonomous existence? Semi-autonomous existence. Semi-autonomous existence. Because the mitochondria, they have their own DNA. Because of having their own DNA, they have the property of self-replication. And generally we can say that the mitochondria and other organelles, how the organelles are produced in the new dividing and you see the descending cells. The number of the mitochondria or other organelles that is maintained after the division of the cell, it is because of what? It is because the organelles including the mitochondria, the other organelles are produced from, some organelles are produced from other organelles, or the organelles are produced from the pre-existing organelles by division process. They have, the mitochondria have their own DNA, they have a self-replication property, because of which the mitochondria, they are called, they have a semi-autonomous existence in the cell. So, dear students, it is clear that mitochondria, they are involved in the process of the cellular respiration, they are involved in the process of generation of the energy in the form of ATP, and thus help in the process, and this ATP is used in all other metabolic reactions of the cell to perform all the biochemical activities of the cell, or even the other activities which the animal or the plant performs. Other biological activities, they are the process of the growth, the reproduction property, and other chemical reactions, they also need this energy. And the eukaryotic cells, we know they have the mitochondria, but the other cells, just like you see the prokaryotic cells, they have no mitochondria. How these prokaryotic cells, they will oxidize glucose and generate their energy? Prokaryotic cells, suppose this is the prokaryotic cell having no well organelle nucleus. This prokaryotic cell, they have the membrane. The membrane at some places, the membrane of a prokaryotic cell that folds at some places to form structures. These structures are called mesosomes. These structures are called mesosomes. These are the infolding of the membrane of the prokaryotic cells. These mesosomes, they perform the properties, they have the properties just like the cysts of the mitochondria. That meaning the mesosome, the infoldings of the cell membrane, they have property to produce oxidative enzymes. Produce oxidative enzymes, and thus the mesosomes, they perform this property of cellular respiration. Dear students, let us see. Number 3 is Golgi bodies. Golgi bodies, these are the organelles, membrane bounded organelles. Golgi bodies. In the plant cells, they are also called lipochondria. The Golgi bodies in the plant cells, they are also called lipochondria. It is lipochondria mean for the Golgi bodies and only in plant cells. The Golgi bodies, they were discovered by a scientist, Camillo Golgi, and because of the name of the scientist Golgi body, the cell-like structures, they were named Golgi bodies. A Golgi body is actually this. The Golgi body is, these are the flat and sac-like structures. Golgi bodies are the flat and sac-like structures. Flat and sac-like structures. These flat and sac-like structures, they possess inside, they possess vesicles. They possess vesicles. The vesicles inside, vesicles that meaning pouch-like structures. These vesicles are the pouch-like structures within the Golgi bodies. They are called sister for singular cisterna, and after E they are pronounced as cisterni, and it is for plural. Cisterni, these are the sac-like structures, or these are the vesicles inside the Golgi bodies. A cluster of the Golgi bodies always exist in cluster form, in a group form. The cluster of the Golgi bodies is called Golgi apparatus. A cluster of the Golgi bodies is called Golgi apparatus. Golgi apparatus. A Golgi apparatus meaning a cluster or a group. Animal cells, they have one Golgi apparatus, while the plant cell, they have many Golgi apparatus. In animals, the Golgi bodies, they help in the process of formation of enzymes. Golgi bodies are also involved in the process of formation of hormones, proteins, and you see the enzymes. But in case of the plants, the Golgi bodies, they also produce, they help in the production of enzymes and hormones, but they perform in other function in plant cell. They produce carbohydrate materials. These materials include cellulose, hemicellulose, and you see the lignin and pectin compounds. These lignin and pectin compounds, they are also the carbohydrate molecules, and you see the materials produced in plant cell. The materials produced by the Golgi bodies in plant cells, they get accumulated, get stored, they get diffused out of the cell membrane and get accumulated over the cell membrane, and the great accumulation of the carbohydrate materials, they finally at the end, all these carbohydrate molecules at the end, they get fused within each other to form the cell wall. It means Golgi bodies in plant cell, they help in the formation of the cell wall. They are not only involved in the formation of the cell wall in the plant cell, they are also involved in the formation of the cell plate too. Cell plate is a partition wall formed after karyokinesis, after the division of the nucleus. When the nucleus is divided into two parts in plant cell, the cell plate is formed that divides, separates the two cells from one another, and thus we can say that the Golgi bodies in plant cell, they help in the formation of the plant cell division. And dear students, and that's all. Inshallah, I will discuss our lecture in other cytoplasm carbonates in our next lecture. Thank you.